Hi everybody. So today we're going to talk about GitHub Copilot. GitHub Copilot is the rave of the moment for all software developers, right? It is so awesome. So once again, I welcome you back to my channel. This is my name is Chidi, and if this is your first time here, kindly subscribe. It's a way to encourage me to share my thoughts. And if this is your first time, if you're a returning subscriber, you know the drill. Kindly like, comment, and share this video. Let's get started. So GitHub Copilot. Yes, they say it's a very shiny new feature or a new shiny service by GitHub and the OpenAI. If you're new to the OpenAI, I think you need to go make a research about it. OpenAI is an artificial intelligence product that is majorly owned by Microsoft. So in essence, it is not open. It is a Microsoft technology. So back to our discussion. So GitHub Copilot can be used in Visual Studio Code. It's a plugin that you activate, you download in Visual Studio Code. And how it works is, as you're typing your code as a software engineer, it's suggesting awesome things for you, awesome code bases. Let's say you want to type a function name called drive, for example, drive in such a way that it is for drive car. As soon as you type the function name, it suggests for you what you might want to type next. And it does not just suggest it for you, it learns from the previous code base of the previous codes that you have written, and it learns as well from the millions and millions of code bases on Stack Overflow, GitHub repositories, on the internet, just so to speak. And it makes its own guess as to what you are about to type. So it is an awesome feature. It is so awesome. I love it. I love GitHub Copilot. It is like a beginning of a revolution for AI pair programming. So why it's called Copilot is, yes, as the software engineer, you are the pilot. So it is there as a co-pilot to assist you. You know how the pilot's doing in the aircraft, in the airplane. So that's basically what it does. It assists you for when you need it most, or for when you are so lazy to finish up writing a particular code base, and you find that it has given you the awesome suggestion that you are expecting, or that you can make use of. You can just select that option. So the way it works is, it will select a number of options for you as you're typing, and you can scan through those options. You can even modify those options on the fly, and you can as well choose the particular option to auto-populate what you were already working on. So the one other perception that a lot of programmers are having is, there is this question around the block that, is it not going to take away our jobs anytime soon as software engineers? that is a very, very important point to note, because GitHub Copilot is an AI, and you know what AI is? Artificial intelligence, which means it keeps learning from data. It can learn from as much data as possible. And let's not forget that it could learn to the extent that one day it could write a complete software for itself. And if you think about it in the other way, critically, you could find out that a time would come when it would not depend on human beings. Yes, for now it is at the pilot stage. It is still learning. It is still developing. The creators of GitHub Copilot, the AIs, they said it has just 54% accuracy. But yeah, something that has 54% accuracy, of course, with time it would get to 56, 57, until it get to 99% accuracy. And you know what that means? It means that if you are a software developer, nobody needs you anymore. All they need is one good senior advanced software engineer and a copilot, alongside him in such a way that the pair, the both of them, can write thousands of lines of codes or can write tens of hundreds of softwares within a space of a day. And you know what that means again? Job of software engineers are being scrapped out. So if this is something you don't mind, I think it's a welcome opportunity. GitHub Copilot is good, but everything that has an advantage, they say, also has a disadvantage. So let's enjoy it while it lasts, and let's also be aware that we might not be coding forever. So if you enjoy this topic, if you enjoy this video, we're gonna be getting more awesome videos coming up to your screens. And all you could do for us is to please subscribe to our channel. You can refer people to our channel to learn more, you know, get information on everything that is new in the moment for in the technology industry. Like the video, subscribe, and please let us as well know what you think in the comment section down below. So for today, I'll say thank you and have a blessed day. Bye.